published 2:02 Eastern Standard Time, the 31st of December 2017, updated 7:45 Eastern Standard Time, the 31st of December 2017. A once liberal Oregon college town has been overcome with crime and emboldened groups of white supremacists. The Oregonian spoke recently with several residents in the city of Eugene about the shocking and not-so-secret neo-Nazi extremists who have made their name known across the community. Some of the individuals include two who are said to be the most prominent men, Jacob Lasky and Jimmy Marr. Those guys have been hanging around the movement for years, Carla Hill, investigative researcher for the Anti-Defamation League Center on Extremism, told the local newspaper. Along with other supporters, she said Lasky and Marr see an opportunity to make changes. They dream of Jimmy Marr, who goes by a genocide ahimi on Twitter, is shown inside his home in December. He told the Oregonian, Oregon Live, that he is interested in the counter-extermination of the Jews. Marr spoke about the evolution of his ideas from his home in Springfield, pictured above. Jacob Lasky, pictured in December, was sent to federal prison for 11 years after throwing rocks etched with swastikas into a synagogue in Eugene. He was released in 2015 during Lasky's time in prison. He wrote books, and one of them about his theory that the Holocaust was a hoax. Now, Lasky said he has moved past the incidents, but hasn't denied his support of the groups. They see this is their time, Hill explained, while adding that Marr has been deemed genocide Jimmy by other white supremacy supporters. On Holocaust Remembrance Day in January, supporters gathered outside Marr's home, where swastika flags flew near an elementary school, along with sign that said, "The Holocaust is hokum," the Oregonian reports. "I'll tell you this right now. I'm interested in the counter-extermination of the Jews," Marr told the newspaper during an interview inside his home. As for Lasky, he was released from jail in 2015 after 11 years behind bars for tossing swastika-etched bricks through Temple Beth Israel synagogue in the city. During his time in prison, he wrote books, and one of them about his theory that the Holocaust was a hoax. Marr's address has long been public knowledge. On Holocaust Remembrance Day in January, swastika flags were flown near an elementary school, along with sign that said, "The Holocaust is hokum now." Lasky said he has moved on from his past, but hasn't denied his support. "Yes, I'm proud of my race. Yes, I'm proud of my heritage," Lasky said. "I'm not a fascist. I'm an American. Why can't we put America first?" A woman working in the cannabis industry in the area, Bethany Sherman, was also accused of having a role in the racist group. In honor of Adolf Hitler's birthday, one resident alleged Sherman baked cookies in the shape of swastikas, the newspaper said. Lasky previously praised Sherman on his YouTube channel and said she is a hero because she doesn't have white guilt. Shortly after the allegations, Sherman was forced to close down her marijuana testing lab after she was reproved by customers and other community members. Bethany Sherman sits in the window of her mother, Sue Sherman's hospital room. Sue was diagnosed a year ago with pancreatic cancer. Sherman has been forced to close down her marijuana testing lab after she was accused of taking part in white supremacy groups. Owners of Aug Analytical, a cannabis testing lab in Eugene, were alleged by Eugene activists to have participated in neo-Nazi activities. Another local business owner, who does not associate with the group, said she has been a target of hate and vandalism after she banned a group of individuals who openly expressed the white supremacist views from her bar. Old Nick's pub owner, Emily Nyman, told the newspaper that a swastika was painted outside her business with a message that said, "We're watching you." Nyman, a supporter of the anti-fascist movement, said she was forced to hire a lawyer and contact the FBI after she was harassed online. Along with her own protection, Nyman said she wishes to help others in Eugene, particularly ethnic minority groups. "As a white businesswoman who has less to fear, I feel like I owe it to the people in my community who can't speak out," Nyman said. Hate crimes in the city of Eugene went up by 44 since 2016 as city officials recorded a total of 60 in 2017. Vandalism and graffiti made up 20% of the hate crimes reported between January and October, the Oregonian reports. This year has seen a flurry of racist and anti-Semitic activity across the city. Vandals have struck cars, storefronts and public property with painted swastikas. Repugnant messages and symbols have defaced schools, churches and the federal courthouse. A local business owner, who does not associate with the group, said she has been a target of hate as well as vandalism. Hate crimes in the city of Eugene went up by 44 since 2016 as city officials recorded a total of 60 in 2017.